starting to remove the diffusion input problems.
So in the simple pass transistor, another problem was VT drop. So we had converted pass transistor into a transmission gate first.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what else?
Sir, output noise sensitivity, to remove that, we put an extra inverter at the output part so that our output sensitivity can be.
Okay. And what is the difference between a latch and a flip flop?
The latch is a level triggered, whereas the flip flop is edge triggered. It only samples at the edge, the flip flop.
And what about so what do you mean by level triggered and edge triggered? So you did say something about it, but yeah, a little more.
So basically in a level triggered latch, the input is transparent to output for the entire duration of the level to which the latch is sensitive to. While in case of flip flop, it is only sensitive to the edges. The sampling will only occur at the edges.
Okay. So essentially when we say level triggered or edge triggered, we are talking about when is the sequential element transparent, that is at what or during at in which duration will the sequential element sample the data and continue to sample the data. For example, in a level triggered latch, it will continue to sample during the entire low duration or the entire high duration, depending on whether it's a low level latch or a high level triggered latch. Okay. Then what else did we see last time?
So then we saw TSPC.
Okay. But before that, we actually took a step to say that we do not want a dynamic latch. What was that? How did we convert a dynamic latch? So all those pass transistor and transmission gate stuff, all that was dynamic latch. Dynamic latch means the input, the output is being held on a capacitor. It is not driven at all times. So what did we do to ensure that we do not have a dynamic latch?
So, sir, we used hanging latch concept. At last, we concluded with the hanging latch.
So we added a feedback.
Feedback path at the feedback, you would add an inverter followed by a tri-state buffer, which would actually hold back the capacitance value.
Yeah, so for the feedback, we decided to add a tri-state buffer so that it does not interfere in the latch operation or in the sampling operation on the forward path. But it does ensure that the latch is no longer dynamic, and that whatever data it is, whether it is 0 or a 1 that I am storing in the latch, is maintained through the feedback mechanism. Am I right? So we also talked about one more thing when we talked about this latch and its latch SNM and all that. What was that one concept we talked about? What is SNM?
Static noise margin.
And we talked about one concept when we wanted to say that we want to measure static noise margin or estimate static noise margin. How do we estimate static noise margin?
So butterfly curve, by the method of butterfly curve.
Yeah, so we look at the butterfly curve and we say the largest square or the side of the largest square that we can fit into the smaller of the two lobes, that is my SNM. So we introduced this topic, but we also agreed that we will understand it in much more detail when we talk about memories later in the course, probably in the second last lecture. Okay, but yeah, with latches and with flops, that is something that we need to be aware of. In addition to which aspect for which we had a guest lecture also?
Metal stability.
meta stability and the concept of tau, that we have to reduce tau to as low a value as possible. So how did Rohit introduce tau, and what did he tell about tau? Hello. Tau. What is tau? So tau. Haan, bolo, Sayan.
Yes, I think it was the time needed for a flip flop to come out of metastability.
Actually, tau was a measure of time when the probability of a latch or a flop being metastable is very high, and that duration is when your data, like your data is expected to arrive before clock arrives. That is the setup time. We will just look into this in more detail. And we said that setup time plus hold time, that is, the sum of these two values is my tau. If you can reduce both setup and hold time, you're reducing tau. You're making your flip-flop more stable. But usually for a given architecture and a given set of sizes, setup plus hold window is kind of frozen. So you may increase the setup and reduce the hold, or you may increase the hold and reduce the setup, depending on your requirements. But this window is usually frozen. However, when you change the architecture, you can actually reduce this window. Okay, so that is what is tau, and a lower value of tau is what is desirable. So how to estimate this tau, or how to estimate setup and hold times, he didn't discuss. Usne bataya tha, but can someone repeat it for me? How do you estimate the setup time of a flip-flop? What is setup time? So let's start from here. What do you know about setup time?
So setup time is the minimum time before which the input should be made available to the flip-flop so that it can be effectively sampled by the edge of the clock.
So Mangesh, you're also saying something?
So same thing.
Okay, so for any sequential element which has a clock in it, we say that the duration for which the inputs should be settled, the minimum duration before the clock arrival for which the inputs should be stable, is the setup time. Okay, and after clock arrival, or active edge of the clock arrival, the minimum duration for which the inputs should remain stable. So pehle, before the clock arrival, how long they have to be stable, and then after the clock arrival, for how long they have to be stable. So this part is setup time, and the other part is hold time. Okay, and the sum of these two is tau. So the duration for which you want your inputs to be held stable, that is in a sense the measure of tau. Are you with me? Any questions? So what we are talking about is that, yes.
Sir, could you please retreat a few lines back what you have said?
Yeah, I'm repeating. So look at this. We are talking about a latch over here. So the minimum duration, so the negative edge of the clock is the sampling edge for the latch. If it's a positive level triggered latch, then the last sample will be taken at this edge. Are you able to see this?
So we Hello? Can see a I mean, I don't know. I have this problem. Like, I can see only your zoomed in screen. Like, I don't have the full view of your slide.
So you can pin my slide.
No. I have pinned your slide. I can view it as a zoomed screen. I don't know.
It is fine for me at least.
Swapnil, issue is on your end.
Okay.
Are you able to see it properly now? So are you able to see this edge? Are you able to see this edge? The red one.
Yes,
you realize that the latch, while it will sample through the entire positive duration, it will finally sample at this edge. Whatever it samples at this edge will remain valid for the entire low period. Are you able to see this? So the minimum duration for which data has to be held stable before this edge arrives is called setup time, before the sampling edge arrives. Okay. And the minimum duration after the sampling edge for which the data has to be held stable, that is called the hold time. Are you with me?
Sir, I have one doubt here.
Yes.
Sir, if we are talking about a latch, then why the edge is so important here?
Because whatever you sampled on this edge, that is going to be held for the entire low period, is it not? The latch is transparent through this entire positive duration, but in the negative duration, when the latch is opaque, it will hold some data. That is where the latching action has actually happened, is it not? Usse pehle to wo ek inverter kitna behave kar rahi hai. It's behaving like an inverter before that. It actually behaves like a latch only in this duration. Is it not?
Yes,
otherwise,
yes.
It was just an inverter. So in this duration, whatever data it holds, that has to be stable. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So for a positive level triggered latch, the negative edge of the clock is the sampling edge. Are you able to see this? Because whatever it samples here will remain for the entire negative duration. Is this point clear?
Yes, sir.
So the minimum duration or for which the data has to be held stable before the sampling edge is called setup time, and minimum duration after the sampling edge for which the data has to be held stable is called the hold time. Theek hai? I'm giving you a definition in terms of sampling edge, because that definition is independent of whether you have a positive level triggered latch or a negative level triggered latch. A flip-flop, positive edge triggered flip-flop or a negative edge triggered flip-flop. Whatever is the sampling edge, setup time is the duration for which data has to be held stable before that. Whatever is the sampling edge, hold time is the duration for which the data has to be held stable after that. Always remember it from the sampling edge concept, then you will never go wrong. If you remember it from falling edge or rising edge or this or that, you will get confused. You will get confused as soon as the person changes the or the latch is no longer a positive edge triggered latch or something else. Okay, so always look at it from the sampling edge. Is this clear?
So, sir, we can say like hold time and setup time both are depend on the input and output with reference. Like
output ki baat kahan hai?
Like sir, jo output change ho raha hai, high matlab input pe jo changes ho rahe hain, wo output pe reflect ho rahe hain, tabhi usko setup time.
That is a different thing. Abhi to maine yahan pe aaya hi nahi na. Main to output wale waveform pe abhi tak aaya hi nahi. Main to abhi data aur clock ke beech mein ghoom raha hu. Aap output se kaise confuse ho rahe ho? As of now, I am only between input and clock. And I've not even talked about Q yet. Have I talked about Q even once?
No.
Then why did you get confused with output? Setup and hold time is linked only with the input pins. Unless, okay, if you connect the output to the input, then it comes linked to the output also. But otherwise, setup and hold time are measured at the input pins only. Is this clear? Hello?
Not clear. Like T setup, sir. Ek baar fir se bata denge kya?
So setup time means the minimum duration before the sampling edge of the clock for which the data has to be held stable. The input has to be held stable. T hold is the minimum duration after the sampling edge of the clock for which the input has to be held stable.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
This is a very important definition. It should be crystal clear to each one of you. And you should remember it in terms of sampling edge only. Do not remember it in terms of falling edge, rising edge, this, that. You will get confused. Always look at it in terms of sampling edge. It will make it simple for you.
Sir, जो initial sampling edge हो रहा है clock का, PWM जहाँ लिखा हुआ है उससे पहले, वो भी एक तरीके से setup time ही है. तो अगर एक input में बहुत सारे ऐसे setup time आ रहे हैं.
Wait. कौन से वाला? PWM यहाँ लिखा हुआ है तो यहाँ तो डेटा टॉगल ही नहीं करा ना.
नहीं नहीं सर, इससे पहले जो एक एज आ रही है ना डी की, इनिशियल डी हाई हो रहा है
ये वाला. हाँ तो आपका उधर तो इतना सारा ड्यूरेशन मिल गया ना आपको, ये तो सेटअप टाइम की बात ही नहीं हुई. सेटअप टाइम इज द मिनिमम ड्यूरेशन फॉर विच यू नीड टू बी स्टेबल.
ओके,
यू कैन ऑलवेज बी स्टेबल फॉर मच लॉन्गर बिफोर दैट. मिनिमम आपको सेटअप टाइम पहले सेटअप होना चाहिए.
सर बट इसको सेटअप टाइम इसलिए नहीं बोल रहे कि वहां पे क्लॉक नहीं है, लाइक हाई,
बिकॉज़ दैट इज नॉट द मिनिमम टाइम. दिस डेटा, द राइजिंग डेटा हैज आल्सो सेटअप, बट आई एम नॉट कॉलिंग दिस ड्यूरेशन टू बी टी सेटअप बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट द मिनिमम टाइम. दिस इज द मिनिमम टाइम.
बट सर वहां पे तो क्लॉक की एज राइजिंग है ना, तो लाइक सेटअप और होल्ड के लिए हम चेक कर रहे हैं कि जहां पे जो मेरी सैंपलिंग एज है वो फॉलिंग एज होती है.
फॉर अ पॉजिटिव लेवल ट्रिगर्ड लैच, दिस इज द सैंपलिंग एज. सो फॉर दिस सैंपलिंग एज डेटा हैज सेटअप सो लॉन्ग बिफोर.
या सो लाइक
दिस इज नॉट द मिनिमम ड्यूरेशन. आई कैन नॉट बी मेजरिंग सेटअप टाइम लाइक दिस. सेटअप टाइम इज द मिनिमम ड्यूरेशन फॉर व्हिच इट हैज टू बी हेल्ड स्टेबल.
ओके, सो वहां पे स्टार्ट में जो सर्कल किया है डी का चेंज हो रहा है, तो वहां पे वैसे भी हम मेजर नहीं कर सकते ना, क्योंकि वहां पे तो क्लॉक की राइजिंग है जारी.
हाँ, मतलब ये ओके, सो
इफ यू से दिस,
ओके इफ यू से दिस टू बी द सेटअप टाइम, नो दिस इज नॉट द सेटअप टाइम बिकॉज़ दिस इज नॉट द सैंपलिंग एज ऑफ द क्लॉक. दिस इज द सैंपलिंग एज ऑफ द क्लॉक. दिस इज द सैंपलिंग एज ऑफ द क्लॉक.
सर अगर ये जो लैच हम कंसीडर कर रहे हैं पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड होती, तो फिर ये वाली जो टाइम है ये सेटअप टाइम हमारा हो जाता.
अगर आपकी लैच
पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव लेवल ट्रिगर होती,
अगर आपकी लैच नेगेटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड होती, देन यू शुड हैव मेट द सेटअप टाइम हियर. हैड योर लैच बीन अ नेगेटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड लैच,
यस,
देन दिस वुड बी द सेटअप टाइम. बट सिंस दिस इज अ पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड लैच, दिस इज वेयर यू आर मीटिंग द सेटअप टाइम. Is that clear?
Sir, I have one doubt here. Suppose, sir, ये जो हमारा latch है या flip flop है, ये positive edge triggered है.
ये latch है, ये flip flop नहीं है, ये latch है.
Sir, flip flop के case में भी तो setup, मतलब अगर ये
flip flop. Flip flop की next slide, flip flop पे next slide में आएंगे, अभी latch है.
Okay.
अभी latch है. Let's not get confused. अभी latch है, flip flop पे next slide में आएंगे.
Sir, you are mentioning the term positive or negative edge triggered latch.
No, I said positive level triggered latch.
Okay, sir. I think you mistakenly said that.
Many times I'm sorry for that. So I have been talking about positive level triggered latch, negative level triggered latch, positive edge triggered flop, and negative edge triggered flop. Whenever I'm talking about edges, I'm talking about flops. Whenever I'm talking about levels, I'm talking about latches. Okay, so if there is some confusion, let me just clarify that again.
So?
Yes.
So for a case of latch, where we are actually concerned more about the level, not the exact edge triggering. So couldn't we actually, you know, not actually, you know, constrain setup and hold too much and maybe allow it to, you know, expand it, or maybe to expand it to maybe half of the time period so that you can actually.
Yeah, yeah. See, that is what has been done here, na? D was set up so long before the sampling edge came. You will want to do it like that. That is not a challenge, Swapnil. The challenge is, can you always ensure it, or how will you do a sign off? To do a sign off, you have to ensure that this is what has to be met. You have to ensure that this is what has to be met. If these are not met, you have to add delays in either clock path or in data path. Are you with me?
So if you have the, I just have a quick question. Like if you have this as the positive level triggered, then why should you be concerned about if the data is getting held for some duration, like T hold should be there after it has it may happen, like if you are not concerned about T hold, right? Why are we actually concerned about T hold in the case of latch?
Because instead of a flop, you could also have a latch in a circuit path.
Huh.
And there you do not want the new data to come and corrupt the previous set of data. The contamination delay should not lead to corrupting of the entire cycle there. That's why you also want to be sure that hold is not violated. See, setup is to ensure that whatever data you are sending for the evaluation, that is latched properly. And hold is for ensuring that the new data that was sent in from the previous stage does not come and corrupt the data that I have settled into my system. So, chahe wo latch ho, chahe wo flop ho, chahe wo memory ho, whichever sequential element you're talking about, you have to meet setup and hold times for all inputs.
So also, like I guess missed this part when you were explaining this, so maybe I didn't get it properly. Why was the negative edge the triggering point or the sampling point for the positive level triggered latch?
You tell me, when does the latch actually start to operate as a latch? After which edge does the latch actually start to operate as a latch? Before that, it is just a buffer or an inverter. After which edge does it actually behave like a latch?
So I mean, like your data, if you have a positive level triggered latch, when your clock is going from 0 to 1, as in it's changing its level from 0 to 1, then your input data will get sampled to the output, right? Then it will actually behave like a
transparent. Then the latch will become transparent. It will start sampling.
Huh.
When does it finally sample? So then it starts to, when it becomes transparent, it behaves as a buffer or an inverter, is it not? When does it behave as a latch?
Okay, when you actually have a falling edge, or tab usko sample karta hai, kyunki tab pata hai wo data transition nahi karega.
Yes, let the data transition now. My latch is sampled.
Sampled.
Okay. Now it is opaque.
Huh.
It will not let any new changes come in. Which edge is that? That is a negative edge for a positive level triggered latch.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
ठीक है.
Uh-huh.
So these are the setup and hold times. Then we understand that the output of a latch could be governed by clock coming after data in which case we call it as TCQ, that is delay from clock to Q, or output could also be governed by data toggling and leading to a toggle in the output, in which case it is called as TDQ. So data to Q or clock to Q. So now I am talking about the output. Okay, output also has two timings associated with it, TCQ and TDQ. Which timing is to be used for your sign off, for your analysis, is determined by whether this whether it was the clock that led to the output change or whether it was a data change that led to the output change. Is this aspect clear?
Sir, एक doubt.
Hmm.
Yeah, so like ये जो concept है clock to queue and data to queue, क्या वो like in dynamic gates भी हम मतलब उसमें लगेगा क्या? है ना? Like उसमें भी तो clock है मेरी तो.
Whichever circuit has a clock, all these will come into picture.
Okay, so like then two delays या जो भी मतलब ये उसमें contamination delay आएगा और propagation delay आएगा. तो हर एक के लिए मतलब क्लॉक के लिए अलग होंगे और ड्यू टू क्लॉक अलग होंगे और ड्यू टू डेटा भी अलग होंगे, राइट?
यस.
ओके ओके सर,
ठीक है.
यस सर,
सो आगे बढ़े. सो इफ दिस इज क्लियर, द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड विल बी वेरी क्लियर ऑटोमेटिकली. आई वांट दिस टू बी क्लियर
सर. सॉरी सर कि फिर से डिस्टर्ब कर रहा हूँ. लाइक सर, जो मैं टी सेटअप से समझाऊँ, लाइक कि क्लॉक आने से पहले मेरा जो स्टेबल इनपुट होने के लिए जो टाइम ड्यूरेशन है वो टी सेटअप है ना. तो वही सर, उसमें जहाँ पे जो टी सेटअप यहाँ पे दिखाया गया तो क्लॉक में ही दिखाया गया, वो चीज कंफ्यूज कर रही है. लाइक
क्या क्या
कि यहाँ पे हमारी पॉजिटिव एज है, पॉजिटिव लेवर है, उसी में हम लोग टी सेटअप कैसे दिखा पा रहे हैं, वो चीज एक बार समझा रहे.
सी, क्लॉक का सैम्पलिंग एज क्या है, ये वाला है ना सैम्पलिंग एज.
क्योंकि मैं तो सर ये समझ रहा हूँ कि जैसे जो PWM है ना, वहां पे जो लेफ्ट में दिखा रहा है, तो उसके जो यहाँ पे डी इनपुट, तो जो चेंजेस हो रहा है वो मतलब क्लॉक के आने से पहले वो सेटअप टाइम होना चाहिए था
ना. भाई क्लैरिफाई कर रहा हूँ नमन, तुम जो समझ रहे हो तुम फ्लॉप से कंफ्यूज हो रहे हो. मैं इसीलिए व्हाट आई एम देयरफॉर स्ट्रेसिंग इज डोंट लुक एट इट. Don't look at a latch and a flop differently. Just always look at it as a which is the sampling edge for my sequential element. If you start to look at it from the perspective of the sampling edge, then you tell me which is the sampling edge over here. This one or this one? After which
PWM,
edge?
PWM.
This is the sampling edge?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by sampling edge then? Chalo, ye batao.
Like jahan
because then possibly that is where our definitions are not matching and that is where you are getting confused. So what do you mean by sampling edge?
Jahan pe sir hamara input jo output pe reflect kar sakte hain. Clock ka wo period jahan pe hamara input output pe reflect ho.
Nahi. To tum period ki baat karo, main edge ki baat puch raha hu.
Which duration of जहां पे मतलब लाइक लेवल ट्रिगर में सर, जब पॉजिटिव लेवल ट्रिगर तो वहां पॉजिटिव लेवल ट्रिगर ड्यूरेशन तक हमारा इनपुट की वेरी इनपुट सैंपल होगा वहां पे.
हाँ, तो इस पूरे ड्यूरेशन में इनपुट सैंपल होगा, बट आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट सैंपल ड्यूरेशन, आई एम आस्किंग अबाउट सैंपलिंग एज. व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय सैंपलिंग एज? You talked about sampling duration. You are absolutely right in that. I'm not challenging that. I'm asking you, what is sampling edge according to you?
I don't know, sir.
So let us come to a common definition of sampling edge first. Then it will be easy for you to understand setup and hold. Is that okay?
Okay, sir.
So what I am talking as a sampling edge over here is the edge after which your latch will not sample any more data. After which the latch will actually operate as a latch. Because during this transparent duration, the latch is actually operating as a buffer or an inverter. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So during the sampling duration, a latch operates as a buffer. At what edge, after what edge will the latch actually operate as a latch and not as a buffer?
So falling edge ke pass mein.
Yes. So I am calling this as the sampling edge.
Okay, sir. Got it.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
I'm not talking about sampling duration. I'm talking about sampling edge. Because as soon as I talk about sampling edge, you can handle flop and latches in a very similar manner. You will not get confused. Otherwise, anyone can confuse you anytime. Is this part clear?
Yes, sir.
Aage bane?
Yes, sir.
So now when we come to the flop, then the sampling edge, if it's a positive edge triggered flop, then CK rising edge is the sampling edge. And your setup and hold are both defined like this. And T setup plus T hold is equal to tau. Tau that you would use in your metastability analysis. And since in a flop, there is no concept of data being sampled in a duration, data is all anyway sampled only at the clock edge, there is only one output delay, which is TCQ. Let the data toggle as many times over here, doesn't matter, output is not going to toggle. The data has to be set up before the rising edge of the clock, and then output will naturally sample it. Output will naturally get it after TCQ. Are you with me? Any questions here? This should be simple after the initial first slide.
Sir, we can define this tau for the latch also, right? Because in latch also, in the sampling edge, there will be a T setup before the edge and a
yes.
Yes.
But see, यहाँ पे वो अलग अलग जगह पे दिखाया हुआ था इसलिए I didn't want to bring that thing here. But yes, you are absolutely right. If I was to define setup and hold at this place itself, suppose I would have taken data to low level over here and said that this is my hold, then tau could be defined here also. If I had done it like this, I could have told you about tau here also. Since the waveform was simpler, I did not talk about tau yet. In this case, I can easily talk about tau. But you're right. Latch also has a similar value of tau. Okay?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, आगे बढ़े. Is this clear? So since we've spent so much time on the flop and we're talking of it always in terms of sampling edge, so this slide should be much simpler for you now. Any questions?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, here it is written that delays can be different for rising and falling data transitions means अगर पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड है तो सेटअप होल टाइम और नेगेटिव एज पे सेटअप होल टाइम डिफरेंट हो सकते हैं यही मीनिंग है ना
सो व्हाट दिस मींस इज दैट टीसीक्यू ओवर हियर कैन बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम टीसीक्यू ओवर हियर
And sir, what about setup and hold time? We don't have to consider that.
Setup and hold time could also be different for rising and jo aap, see that is what you are already observing in your projects also, na? That rising and fall delays can be different. So setup and hold times can also requirements can be different.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. आगे बढ़े
सर. वन क्वेश्चन सर, व्हाई देयर वाज स्पेसिफिक मेंशन ऑफ टी डी टू क्यू इन द लैच केस एंड नॉट हियर?
बिकॉज इन अ लैच इफ इन द सैम्पलिंग ड्यूरेशन देयर इज अ टॉगलिंग इन डी, आउटपुट विल टॉगल बिकॉज ऑफ डी ट्रांजिशन, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ क्लॉक ट्रांजिशन. सो देयर इज दिस डिले दैट कम्स इनटू पिक्चर. This kind of a delay does not even hold true for a flip flop. In a flip flop, whether this toggle happens or not doesn't matter. Whatever is the value of, if it's a positive edge triggered flop, whatever is the value of D over here, that is what is going to define the output. There is only one clock transition that can lead to a transition in the output. Data transition has no role to play in the output. That is where TDQ doesn't exist for a flop. यहाँ पे TDQ exist करता है, ये आपको समझ में आ गया पहली बात?
Yes sir, okay, got it, yes sir.
Okay, so then इधर TDQ आ ही नहीं सकता, because whenever the data toggles doesn't matter. Let data toggle 10 times over here, output is not going to toggle, so there is no TDQ concept. Okay? So should we move forward then?
Yeah. The latch case, then output delay can be characterized as a sum of TCQ and TDQ for over a given time period or something like that.
Not as sum of those.
Okay.
Depending on whether your data came before the sample duration started, or whether your data came in the sample duration, you would either use TCQ or TDQ.
Okay.
This is not sum of those two.
Okay.
ओके आगे बढ़े.
यस सर.
ओके सो दिस इज व्हाट वी जस्ट टॉक्ड अबाउट, दैट द डेटा हैज टू बी हेल्ड स्टेबल फॉर टी सेटअप प्लस टी होल्ड, एंड वी ऑल्सो सेड दैट there could be a contamination delay and there could be a propagation delay for a flop and a latch both. Okay, now how do we characterize the setup and the hold times? Let's come to that. So you know what you will see is that when you will bring data edge close to the clock edge, you will notice that the output waveform will start to change. And at some point, the output will not even register that the new data was there. So what you do is, you define the clock rising edge, or the sampling edge, whether it's a flop or a flip-flop, let's talk about it as a sampling edge. You define the sampling edge, and then you change your data long before the sampling edge, infinite, you know, long before the sampling edge. You will get some delay, TCQ. Now you bring the data transition closer to the sampling edge and continue to measure TCQ. You will notice that after some time, TCQ will start to rise. Exactly, jaisa yahan pe waveform mein dikh raha hai. Are you able to see this? That when you will come close to the sampling edge, TCQ will start to rise in a flop. And that is where you then say that this is when the rise is 1.05 of the standard TCQ, you say that is my setup time. The same thing happens for the hold time also. Okay, so let me show it to you again. Let us say that this is the clock rising edge. or the sampling edge, the clock falling edge in a latch, and I bring data close to clock. Okay, I continue to bring it closer and closer and closer. When I bring it very close, what I notice is that the output TC, the CK to Q delay starts to rise. Okay, and that is what I define as my setup time. Over here, you see this transition has started to fail. Okay, so that is how I define the setup time. Similarly, for the hold time. Are you able to see this? So to characterize the setup and hold time, you have to bring the data transition close to the sampling edge. When this sampling edge is, or when the delay starts to increase by 5%, that is where you say you have the setup time and the hold time. Is this clear?
So essentially, we're registering the setup time till that point, after which the TCQ will be so large that you can't actually register the output. So you will reach the critical value to this graph to actually characterize the setup.
Yes. Time. So what happens is that your TCQ, so the next step, the next thing that we'll start to look at is the sequencing, the timing sequencing. So we'll see that the TCQ is a very important component of overall combinational path delay, overall delay that you have to match and ensure that this is your, that your path is going to be functioning fine. So if TCQ rises by more than 5%, then whatever margins that you may have kept in your sign off can start to fail, because they can accumulate over multiple stages of flops. And therefore you say that not more than 5%. In some companies or in some cases, you may say just 2.5%, because you want to be very, very safe, no failures at all. Okay. So, but 5% is something that you can assume to be standard for now. Whichever company you join and wherever this is, wherever you need to characterize, if they have a specification different than 5%, you just use that specification. But this is the methodology. Is the methodology clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Okay. Okay. So now we come to sequencing timing constraints. So why do we need to look at sequencing timing constraints? Because what happens is that, for example, in a flip-flop, I have two flip-flops in between which I will have some combinational logic. I have to ensure that whatever data I push out from here at this rising edge should pass through the entire combinational logic and be available with setup at this flop before the next rising edge of the clock comes. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, the same thing you have to ensure for latches, pulse latches, and two-phase transparent latches. So why two-phase transparent latches? Any idea? So flop wala clear ho gaya, hai na? Now, after the flop thing is clear, I am saying instead of flops, we could use latches also. Latches are, what do you say, much smaller in size, so I can use latches. So if I can use latches, then why am I using two-phase transparent latches? Why a single latch was not sufficient?
So if you use a single latch, suppose for example, the latch is high level, the latch is transparent for level high. In that case, when my level is high, effectively my whole pipeline is transparent. And now I can have contamination from different tokens. Ideally, I want a separation between them. In case of flip-flop, I had a separation because the point at which I'm transparent is just a single instance.
But when I have a latch, then half the the time period in which I am high, the whole time I would be transparent, which will cause contamination of inputs and outputs.
Yes. So is this point clear to everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Everyone? So what we are essentially saying is that if it was a positive edge triggered latch, then through this entire duration, my system is transparent. While this is good in one way, this also can lead to contamination delays, contamination of my previous cycle. Because as a designer, my intent would always be then to increase the duration of the positive period, because that means I will be able to sample, or I can then put a lot of combinational logic in this duration. If I have a short high duration, then I can put only as much of combinational logic here, because I have to meet the setup time. So I can only put a small amount of combinational logic. So I would want to increase this duration. And as soon as I do that, contamination delays start to play a spoil sport. So I do not want that to happen, and therefore I keep a limited duration of high period. When I keep a limited duration of high period, then this entire duration is getting waste. I can have a separate combinational logic which would operate in the other phase of the clock. Okay. Another way to handle this contamination delay problem for latches is you just give a very, very small pulse width. So when you give a very small pulse width, what happens? You've actually just sampled instead of here, here. So you've actually just made it almost like a flop. A pulse latch is almost like a flop. So there are two ways to use latches in sequencing. One is have two phases of latches, one operating at phi 1 and the other operating at phi 2, and there is a non-overlap duration in between. Okay, so that contamination doesn't happen. Or have a very short high pulse so that you sample within that pulse and then you have the entire duration to evaluate your combinational paths.
Sir, last wala samajh mein nahi aaya ki kaise wo evaluate hua. Second wala two phase wala clear hai ekdam.
तो लास्ट वाले में क्या नहीं समझ में आया?
We were talking in the first case that when we are having the rising part of our clock, so that we can do much of our combination work there. But in this case, in the last case, you are having a smaller pulse width, but you are having a falling of the clock. Means the clock is not rising.
Yeah, what I'm saying is I will sample here. Okay, I will sample previous paths output here, and then I will have the entire duration to work with the combinational logic, and this I will start to sample here, but finally I will sample here. I will start to sample at the positive edge of the clock, but finally I will sample at the negative edge. So over here you are kind of creating a sliding window. Chota sa sliding window aapne create kar diya hai. And so that if this combinational path is short, then the next pipeline stage would start to operate here itself. However, if this pipeline stage is long, then you can sample it until here and you will still be fine. So in a pulse latch scenario, you have created a little bit of extra window for you where you can slide a little bit. You can have some stages which are a little shorter and other stages which are a little longer. And their gap or the difference between them can be your pulse width. Is this clearer? I don't know. Does this help?
Yes, sir.
So if you go to Intel, you will see that they will almost exclusively use pulse latches. in the very high performance circuits. Because over here you have this additional flexibility and you do not need to do timing sign off like you don't need to add delays for a very regimented flop kind of a design. A flop design is very simple. A flop based sequencing design is very simple. A pulse width based design is slightly complex because now you have to consider about two edges. But it is good because it now offers you some sliding window there.
So, okay. Sir, is there a disadvantage of using pulse latches? Otherwise, everyone would have used the pulse latches only. This.
Yeah, the disadvantage is that this pulse needs to be routed. This pulse needs to travel. Hai na? See, in a clock path, you will see lots of RC delays coming in. When you're only talking about one edge, this RC delay, what it will do, it will only delay your edge. It can degrade its slope. Okay, it will degrade its slope. But it will essentially delay. But when you talk about a pulse propagating through a RC path, what happens? The first edge will get delayed and degrade. And by the time the first latch was the first edge was even rising, the driver over here, its input had already fallen. So its input had already risen. So it stops to drive the falling edge. It stops to drive it further, and you do not even reach full VDD. So the pulse width dies. Are you able to see this? So just experiment yourself also. Give a short pulse to a big RC network. You will notice that this pulse will only reach there as a small noise. You will have to make the pulse wider so that it is observed as a pulse over here. Okay, so with pulse latches, designing of the clock tree can become an issue. The solution is you generate this pulse from the rising edge of the clock inside your latch itself. But that means you have to have a pulse generator inside your latch. Aap kya chah rahe the? You wanted a very small latch. Aap to ek transmission gate se latch banane ko tayar the. वो तो हमने पीछे पढ़ पढ़ के यू नो वी गॉट दीज इन्वर्टर्स एडेड द फीडबैक एडेड एंड सो ऑन दैट वाज समथिंग वी डिड बिकॉज़ वी सेड दिस इज नॉट अ गुड लैच बट वी वांटेड एज मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर्स एज पॉसिबल इनसाइड द लैच नाउ वी आर सेइंग हैव अ पल्स जनरेटर इनसाइड द लैच दैट्स अ ह्यूज एरिया पेनल्टी आर यू एबल टू सी दिस
Okay, sir.
Sir.
So yes.
Sir, in the two-phase transparent latches, during the T non-overlap time, the combination logic will evaluate, right?
It will evaluate even during the high time.
Okay.
As soon as the inputs are available, combination logic will start to evaluate.
Yes.
But sir, that output wouldn't be right output because ultimately
if my inputs have become stable. The output will be the right output, is it not?
But sir, if the inputs are not stable, then the final output we will get during the T non-overlap time, right? If the inputs are not.
Yeah. If the inputs are toggling until the sampling edge of the latch, then the combination logic will operate only after that. Wo toh logical hai na baat.
Yes.
Combination logic does not have anything to do with sampling edge. Combination logic simply says, give me a stable input, I will give you a stable output in this duration.
Okay, sir.
That's it?
Yes.
Hello? So is this thing clear? All the three methods of sequencing?
Sir, what my point is, if the inputs, we are considering the setup times. So in case of two-phase transparent latches, my correct output of the first latch would be the output that would that is before the correct hold time constraints of the first latch.
So wait, let us say this latch, okay, phi 1. So if the inputs of this latch are toggling until here, okay, it will set up here and I will have this entire duration for the first combinational logic to evaluate. Do you see this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now I got your point. Okay. Thank you.
For the second thing, this combinational logic will have entire duration until here. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Until
yes, sir.
This falls. Okay. So this entire duration, the second combinational logic will have. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, okay. So this is just a description of contamination delays and propagation delays. We've already discussed this. We're talking about TPD, logic propagation delay, contamination delay, and we're talking about so PD and CD. When I'm talking about these, I'm talking about combinational logic. Okay. Then this nomenclature is important. TPCQ and TCCQ. These are propagation and contamination delay from clock to Q for both latch and flip-flop. Okay. TPDQ and TCDQ, propagation data to Q and contamination data to Q, exist only for the latch. They don't exist for the flop. This we've already discussed. And then setup and hold for both latch and flop. Based on this definition of timings, we will start to look at sequencing constraints. ठीक है, दिस इज जस्ट अ टेबल टू टेल यू अबाउट कि हम आगे क्या स्टैंडर्ड टर्मिनोलॉजी यूज करने वाले हैं. इज दिस क्लियर? एनी क्वेश्चंस हियर? आगे बढ़े फ्रेंड्स.
यस सर.
दिस इज एन एसिंक्रोनस सिस्टम बिटवीन अस. I need an acknowledgement token to proceed. Okay. Okay. So, but before we move much ahead and look into timing constraints or sequencing constraints, what is important to realize is that there are uncertainties on the clock. So, अभी तक जब हम बात कर रहे थे, we just always talked about something with respect to the clock rising edge or falling edge, basically clock sampling edge. But the fact of the matter is that on silicon, when we finally put a circuit, there will be variations in the sampling edge arrival time. Okay. Why would those variations happen? First, the PLL that is generating the clock would have its own jitter. It would generate some edge a little earlier, some edge a little later. Then there are device delays. So we talked about the clock tree network, that the clock has to be routed from your PLL to the clock nodes of your flip-flops, clock input of your flip-flops. So these devices, they will have their own mismatch. All of you have done Monte Carlo. You've seen how the mismatch changes, how the delays can change a little bit, but they can change. Hena? Then there are RC delays. Resistance can also vary across two flops. You know, suppose I have a huge chip, I make my PLL over here and then I make a clock tree. Okay, you will see a clock tree is like a fractal network, let us say something like this. I make a clock tree. Now I have consciously put exactly same path length from here to here and from here to, let us say, here. So any of the leaf nodes, I have myself tried to put exactly same path length, but these are two different parts of the chip. This part could have slightly more etching because of lower density of metals, and this part could have lesser etching because of higher density of metals. So resistances over here can be slightly higher than over here. So the delays can change on between this node and this node. I tried to design it same, but there could be delays, different delays. And there could be a very fast moving wire coming you know, running next to this class, this part of the clock, and this part of the clock may have a static wire next to it. So this wire can have more coupling, this may not have coupling, and therefore nodes which are on this leaf could be faster or slower than the nodes which are on this leaf. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what we are essentially saying is that if I have a pipeline, the clock arrival over here and the clock arrival over here, let us say I have already accounted for these buffers, then the clock arrival over here could be different at different nahi dalte buffers. Let us say hum same hi wo bhej rahe hain. Okay, kuch bhi karke, I have just ensured that I get a T period between them. But are you able to see that due to these, all these uncertainties, this T period can reduce and it can increase? Because this flop could be here and therefore the clock may come faster, or this flop could be here and that flop here. So the T period can increase. What does T period mean? The duration I got to evaluate the combinational logic in between. That duration can increase or shorten depending on all these sources of variation. Are you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
So we have to account for all these uncertainties in our design. Let's look into them in a little more detail. So what is clock skew? Clock skew is, as we discussed over here, the delay, the different delay that my this leaf can see with respect to this leaf or another matched leaf. Okay, that is what is clock skew. Why? Because spatial variation in temporally equivalent clock edges. I mean, dono taraf rising edge hi diya tha. I am looking at the rising edge of the clock, but because my two leaves are separated physically, one is here, the other is here, there could be some difference in the clock arrival time at the two points. That is called as clock skew. What all reasons lead to it? We just talked about them over here. I just introduced them to you over here quickly. But this is what is clock skew. Same edge of the clock, but different arrival times because of spatially far apart location. Even proximity bhi ho to bhi, because of different reasons. Now this is one edge, there could be another edge over here, so the clock could be coming like this. Just because this flop is driven by the other network, this could have different delay than this delay. So proximity hai in dono flops ki. They are very close together, but they are driven by different edge, different leaf of the clock path. Okay, so this is called clock skew. Okay, clock jitter, on the other hand, is a term used for variations in consecutive edges of the clock at the same flop. So I have this leaf. Now I'm not talking about arrival time with respect to the other flop. No, I am saying that due to some coupling here and there, it may happen that in one cycle or at one instance, clock arrives a little earlier than the desired arrival time, and at other times when this coupling is not favoring the transition, the clock arrival could be delayed. Are you able to see this? So this is because of such types of variation like coupling, or because of say IR drop. Yahan pe ekdam se chota sa IR drop ka peak, IR drop hua, zyada IR drop ho gaya, to jo buffers the, they became slower, so the clock arrival came, clock arrived late, or there was a ringing and it rose a little above VDD, so the next clock cycle the rising edge arrived a little early. There could be multiple reasons for jitter also. But important thing to note is there are temporal variations in consecutive edges of the clock signal. This is for the same flop latch. This is for different FF or latch, which are spatially apart. Over here, I'm talking about the same flop. Are you able to see this? See, clock skew, clock jitter, these are very, very common questions that can be asked in the interviews also. So I want you to be absolutely clear about these aspects. Aage bade. So then you have variation in pulse width, which is important for latches. Okay. So, as we just saw, the difference in arrival of clock at two different flops is called skew. Difference in arrival for the same clock edge at the same flop is called jitter. Okay. Both effectively reduce the duration for which you will be able to do the analysis. For example, if you launched through this flop, if you launched through this flop and are sampling on this flop, then effective duration that you can consider for your T combination logic is this. That in a bad case, your clock will arrive a little late. So this is where your operation will start. And on the other flop, it can arrive a little early. So this is where it will end. So you have only this duration to do your analysis instead of this. Are you able to see this? Any questions still here?
So this JS is the minimum duration for which the clock either arrives earlier than the usual time or it either arrives little later than the expected time. That's the difference.
That is the jitter. That is the jitter. You cannot do anything about it. Okay, that is the property of the PLL. And you're not talking about PLL over here.
Yeah.
You cannot really do anything about it. Skew, you can still do something about. Because we're talking about the insertion delay between this node and this node. We could still do something about skew.
Using buffers and everything. You can have the
routers. Yeah. But jitter, you cannot really do much about.
So you could handle jitter in the CTS process also, right? Like you can add buffers. I mean.
Yeah. So if we can remove the coupling sometimes, yes. But then the fact is, kitna kar loge? Because there could be airdrops that can happen. They will lead to jitter. There is a intrinsic jitter because of thermal noise that the PLL will give. So jitter will remain there. You can improvise it, whatever. But this window is actually practically lost for you.
So STA cut rate time, we actually add the JS factor.
Yeah. So we will just do STA ourselves. Okay. We'll just do STA ourselves.
Okay.
Okay. So these are referred to as clock uncertainty. And in reality, there would be a variation of skew. And that variation is dependent on insertion delay. जितना लॉन्ग पाथ होगा उतना ज्यादा आपका स्क्यू का वेरिएशन होगा एंड यू वुड से दैट मैक्स क्लॉक स्क्यू इज दिस डेल्टा you may say plus minus 3 sigma of this center point. Okay. Now this is intrinsic slew. You've not added or removed anything from it. Just because of the fact that there is a long path between two nodes after the clock point had separated, those paths can vary, and therefore you could have clock skew. Okay. So now we come to the concept of positive skew and negative skew. So what according to you is positive skew?
Sir, it's the skew which helps us relax our set of time constraints a bit, because like even before the input is stable, like the clock arrives a little bit later, so I can vary my input for a long time, for a little bit longer time before stabilizing it. So in a way it relaxes my constraints.
Yeah. So agar hum is tarah se dekhein, the clock arrival time at the second flop is already slightly delayed. Clock arrival time at the second flop is already slightly delayed. So aapne jab first rising edge se kuch combinational logic mein evaluation shuru karwaya, because the second flop actually has a rising edge later, you got TCLK plus delta for your combinational logic. So this is positive skew, because you've added more flexibility for your combinational path. Are you able to see this? Hello? Are you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But this is one aspect of it. There is another aspect that you have to look over here. See, the contamination delay after the clock edge, now has to include this delta also in it. Had both the flops received the clock here itself, then only the hold time of the flop was important to you. But now you have to ensure that the previous inputs are stable at least until this part. Is this thing clear to you? Because first thing, T hold to aapko ensure karna hi tha. Now the rising edge is arriving late. So you also have to ensure that the output of this flop remains stable for this delta duration also. So positive skew helps you in the overall evaluation time. So you can put a longer combinational path there, but it has a repercussion on the contamination delay part. Is this thing clear? Hello?
Essentially, you would have a longer hold time. That is what you mean to say, right?
You would require the fastest combinational path to be longer than delta plus H now. Delta plus TH now, instead of just TH. The fastest combinational path between the two flops has to be longer than delta plus TH now, instead of just TH.
So, I'm kind of trading off my setup time for hold time.
Yes. I would not say trading off setup time for hold time. Flop ke liye setup, yeah, latch ke liye setup and hold time are already fixed.
I mean, like the effective thing, of course, like not the set because they're intrinsic to the flip flop, but the effective, like, I don't know how
to explain. Just sliding your timing window. Yeah, just sliding your clock window to get more flexibility. That's it.
Yeah.
Let us put it like this. Okay, you're just sliding your time window, clock window, to get more flexibility. You're not changing the setup and hold time.
Yeah.
That you can't do. That you can't do from outside.
Yeah, those are the like device things I can't change.
Yeah, exactly. So if in a interview question you respond like this, they will say, "Isko to aata hi nahi kuch." Be careful with the words.
There should be better terminology. Like, how do I describe this? Like, effective setup time is definitely not what I wanted to say, but
yeah. So that is what I am saying, Setu. Be careful. Be careful. And this is not just you. So many people amongst us. My Kalpurson, in the last class also, I was pointing out, no, we're not talking about this. We're talking about that. You know, earlier in the class, data ki output ki baat nahi se aage thi. But I was only talking about inputs. So be careful what you're speaking. That is important. Because in technical domain, you have to be exact. You cannot be, okay, chal jayega. It doesn't work like that. Silicon will fail. We don't accept that. Okay?
Yeah. Thank you.
Theek hai? Yeah. Aage padhe? So what do you expect the negative skew to do?
Launching edge arrives after the receiving edge.
Yes. The negative skew, in the presence of a negative skew, you get shorter duration for your combinational path to evaluate. And your hold requirement is actually kind of mitigated altogether. Almost. See, if the hold was to be here, this whole time will never get violated. Because launching edge nahi diya kuch, to kaise violate karega? The contamination delay is not even a botheration for you now.
So this will only hold if, so the hold time violation can only be ignored if the delta is sufficiently long. I mean, if I take...
That's what I said, na? Tabhi maine TH yahan bana diya tha. That was there.
Yeah.
I'm smart. I'm smart. I did that already. Theek hai?
So,
yes.
So, in the previous case, like as in, like if I already have TCLK plus delta as the evaluation time for my combination logic, right? So, we'll obviously get the output after that time, right? But in the meantime, if you're like what we are saying that you, if you only had the TH and you didn't had like added the delta wala, usko jo humne add karke uska increase nahi kiya tha contamination delay ko count karne ke liye. The thing would happen ki hamara jo input tha wahan pe combination path ke out logic pe, that would have got changed, right? And the input jo hamara pehle evaluate ho raha hoga wo to aapko TCLK ke baad mil jata, right? So suppose I didn't account for the delta part in the previous case. So I would have actually, you know, evaluated TCLK plus delta pe, so I would have got the equivalent.
So suppose you had not accounted for delta and your data changed here.
ठीक है, मेरा input correct हो जाता है वो.
हाँ, you able to see this? So जो previous cycle आपका जो यहाँ का output था, जो आपका combination logic को evaluate करके आपको यहाँ sample करना था, वो आपने यहीं पे sample कर लिया. इस cycle में जो आपको actually operation करना था, वो आपका lose हो गया, है ना? So this is not acceptable. So therefore, you have to consider delta plus TH over here.
Yeah.
Okay. So now, if I look at this set of two flip-flops and the combination logic between them, and I ask you to find the minimum cycle time, what would it be?
T setup plus T hold plus T CQ and
plus minus Q.
Yeah.
So let's go step by step, huh? Let's say that hum timing waveform hi bana lete hain. Let us say whichever it arrives early, T minus delta. So time period minus delta, if I have a negative skew, should be greater than or equal to the output going from this flop to the output, it getting set up over here, and the logic delay over here. Okay? So, if you want your circuit to operate at a particular frequency, you can actually estimate what is the longest logic path that you can put over here? Are you with me?
So delta is Q over here, right?
Delta is Q, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
So what about the whole time?
या देखो तुम सवाल बाद में पूछते हो, मैं पहले उधर आ जाता हूँ. देखो है ना, सो फॉर व्हाट हैपेंस फॉर द होल टाइम, फॉर द होल टाइम व्हाट आई वांट इज दैट देयर आर टू क्लॉक्स व्हाटएवर द फास्टेस्ट डिले कंटामिनेशन डिले ऑफ सी टू क्यू प्लस कंटामिनेशन डिले ऑफ दिस लॉजिक शुड बी ग्रेटर दैन टी होल्ड प्लस डेल्टा. Are you able to see this?
Here we are talking about the positive skew, right?
Yes.
If it's a negative, then delta will be negative, right? And the entire thing, entire constraints decreases.
Yeah, exactly. Hai na? Theek hai? So, if this aspect is clear, then we can start to also consider the impact of jitter into it. Where we now say that my jitter, due to jitter, things would arrive a little early or a little late, and therefore, I will see that. So, kya kare? I will see that my flop delay plus logic delay plus setup delay has to be less than desired frequency minus jitter of first edge and jitter of second edge and the skew. Is this clear? Why? Because जिटर की वजह से पहला एज थोड़ा सा लेट आएगा और जिटर की वजह से दूसरा एज थोड़ा सा पहले आएगा. सो आई हैड टू रिड्यूस जिटर ट्वाइस एंड स्क्यू एज यू ऑलरेडी डिड इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड आल्सो. इज दिस क्लियर? हेलो.
यस सर, इट्स क्लियर.
एंड सिमिलरली फॉर द होल टाइम.
So can we say that TJ1 and TJ2 would be equal?
Yeah. So देखो नीचे वाली स्लाइड में हमने ये कर ही दिया, नीचे वाली इक्वेशन में. That is what you just done.
ठीक है,
है ना? ठीक है. And similarly we can do for the whole time. For the whole time we will say this clock came a little earlier and this clock came a little later. So jitter will get added on both this. So again, twice jitter will get added. So you see, minimum C to Q, that is the contamination delay plus logic delay, fastest logic delay has to be lower than TH plus now 2T jitter and delta. Theek hai? So,
sir, it should be greater. I guess this inequality was opposite, right? It should be greater than whole time, not smaller than whole time.
Yeah. Sorry, this has to be like this. Yes. Sorry. Okay. So
why?
We will stop here. We will review this again. Review this timing sequencing again in the next class from this slide onwards. Yes, please tell me. क्या सवाल था?
So I was saying that inequality was सही तो थी. I mean like it had to be lesser than the whole constraint.
No. To cause a violation, it had to be lesser. Actually, what I want is that the contamination delay of my logic plus contamination delay CK to Q, contamination delay of this. Flop or contamination delay plus contamination delay of my logic has to be greater than the hold requirement of the next flop provided there was a positive skew, provided the launching clock came early and the sampling clock came late.
Essentially, we have relaxed the constraints over here a bit.
नहीं रिलैक्स नहीं कर रहे हैं मैंने मैंने ये कह दिया है दैट एड मोर डिले इन द लॉजिक पाथ टी सी क्यू हैज टू बी ग्रेटर दैन देन टी एच प्लस डेल्टा प्लस टू जिटर प्लस माइनस टी सी के क्यू माइनस फ्लॉप डिले बेसिकली
हाँ मतलब टी सी क्यू बढ़ा दिया है हमने लॉजिक डिले का
हाँ लॉजिक डिले मुझे बढ़ाना पड़ेगा आई कैन नॉट हैव वेरी शॉर्ट पाथ्स I cannot have very short paths between two flops. Yes, today's lecture is included in tomorrow's quiz. Not completely, but yeah, jo initial part tha, setup hold and even the early part of sequencing, clock uncertainty, all that is completely covered. We will just look at this timing sequence again in the next lecture, but until the timing sequence, it is all covered, fully covered. So that will be there in tomorrow's quiz. Okay.
Sir, when will this EDA server will start working again?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we're hoping today. So what we are doing is what I've been told is that the IT team has procured a new server, physical new server hardware. They've also installed OS on it. So yesterday, our TAs were testing and they could launch Virtuoso. They could, they did not go ahead and launch Eldo yet. So I think Prakhar or someone would be launching Eldo and checking that everything is working fine for you. And once that happens, they will open it up for you guys. Okay, so hopefully today. Prakhar, am I right? Prakhar was there in the class.
Sir, aaj ka shayad, it's skeptical. We are trying, let's, ek bar Bhavani sir se meeting ho jaye meri, then we can surely tell. But we are trying ki haan, aaj, at least in ke liye we can do the first.
Yeah, so that's what we are trying, that for you guys, it becomes active today itself. Okay. So, anything else?
Sir, we wanted to have a meet with you, like 5-10 minutes.
Yes, Prakhar. So, Sahil, I want to talk to you for a minute.
Okay, so, sir, just a second. So, shall I send you a meeting invite?
Yeah, please do, Prakhar.
Okay, sir. We'll wait there.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
So, I'm stopping the recording. Yes.